Hi and welcome to today's show. I've got a book review for you today. It's Tell Me Why, an award-winning life story by singer-songwriter Archie Roach. The show today is brought to you thanks to the Your Family Story system, which helps you create a life story for a loved one. And I have three sections for this at the end of the show, so please stay with me for all the details. A big g'day if you are new to Forever Young Autobiographies. It's where we learn how to create life stories for friends and family so unique memories can live on. I'd be very grateful if you could follow, subscribe, like the show, or share it with a friend. Now, I was very fortunate to finish this memoir, Tell Me Why, the week that I went to see Archie Roach in concert at my local theatre. It was a sold-out show and he got this wonderful standing ovation at the end. So the full title of the book is actually Tell Me Why, The Story of My Life and My Music. It came out in 2019 by Simon and Schuster Australia, and it was a companion to this album and to this tour, which I mentioned. Now, I felt very lucky to time that well so that I finished the book and then saw the show. But I'd actually listened to this book on as an audiobook. It won the Australian Book Industry Awards Best Audiobook of the Year. And it was read by Roach himself, and you can hear all the wonderful bush noises and other things in the background, not distractingly so, but very authentic. So I highly recommend you listen to the audio version if you can. So in today's show, I'm going to give you a little bit of a bit about what the book was about or is about, things I found interesting and might be interesting to you as a reader, and also what we can take away from Roach's writing for our own life story writing as well. So please stay with me. So first of all, what is this book about? It's 384 pages, so decent read there, but it starts when Roach is in high school. He's sitting in high school and hears what he thinks is his name called out over the speakers to come to the office. He goes to the office and there is a letter addressed to him in his full official birth name, which he hasn't heard or doesn't recognize. And he suspects it's for him and he opens it up. And in this letter, he finds out, he learns about parents and siblings he didn't know existed. He'd been living up until this point with a very loving foster family and had no idea he had this other family out there. And so it's from this point, when he's in high school, he starts to question, what is this life? Who are these other people? And it isn't long until when he's a teen, he travels to Sydney to try and connect with his sister. I won't give it away too much, but he does fall into this alcoholism. He goes to prisons for a short while. He travels down to Victoria, and he eventually meets his soulmate, which is Ruby Hunter. And together they start a family, they sober up, and they start this life of music. So that's a general overview of this autobiography. But what is interesting about this? There's so much I could go on, but things that specifically stood out to me, there's, for example, Roach does boxing with Billy Leach, touring the countryside. He makes music with a famous musician here in Australia called Paul Kelly. He's part of the 1988 bicentennial protests in Sydney. He wins Aria Awards, Australian Record Industry Awards, and he even performs at the 2000 Sydney Olympics. He's got so many stories, he's part of so much history. So that's just a snippet of some interesting things you'll discover in the book. But probably the most interesting thing that I discovered as an Australian, I did not know that many people from the stolen generations didn't know this was part of a wider trend. And so if you're not sure what the stolen generations is, it was the forced removal of thousands of children, Aboriginal Australian children and Torres Strait Islander children, from their families over many decades by governments, by welfare bodies, by churches. And if you'd like to know more about that, of course, read Archie's book or Roach's book, but there is a whole report on that called the Bringing Them Home report. So please check that out. So I found it really interesting that Roach was one of many Indigenous Australians who didn't realise that this was a widespread, coordinated or uncoordinated, but it was done by authorities. So that was a real learning piece for me, very, very interesting. The final thing that I found interesting that I'd like to highlight for this show is that, on a positive note, Roach's songs, they have so much roots in his memories and other people's life stories, which is what we're all about here, aren't we? Life stories. And that really did come through in this book. It was very, very interesting. But for us as life story creators, writers, what can we learn? What can we take away for our own projects? Now, I think Archie or Roach does some great work in putting onto the page dealing with difficult and painful topics. For example, he's talked about addiction, he's talked about crime, there's grief, there's death, then there's him dealing with cancer treatments as well. So he does this with wonderful self-awareness, with vulnerability, and most importantly, he does this with truth. So I think we can take a lot and learn a lot from him on those points. Another thing is that he shows about how places can bring memories to the surface. And I've talked about this recently on another show to do with memory palaces and how places are great for bringing memories to the surface. And he definitely says this in his book. He reinforces it that, you know, going to a location or a place can stir up forgotten memories. It can be for him, it can be for other elders, and for his wife or for his partner, Ruby. She goes back to places, she can remember not just her own memories, but she says there's genetic memories that come to the surface that, you know, could be thousands of years old. So that is a whole nother story, a whole nother rabbit hole, but I thought that was something we can really tap into as life story writers, is to remember that locations, going to a place, will bring these memories back for us. And finally, I wanted to highlight is that, you know, the importance of life story is so important for our identities and for our family. For example, Archie or Roach, he didn't know his parents, but he had immense value on the stories that people could tell him about them. I think that really highlights the importance of sharing these stories, celebrating these stories, and passing them on to future generations. So there you go, guys. That's a bit of a book review. All you ought to know about this stolen child, storyteller and leader, that is Archie Roach. To recap, I've told you a little bit about what the book is about, things I found interesting, and things that we can take away as life story creators. And I hope you'll understand or get the feeling that memories and stories really need to be told. And I think Roach really highlights that in this wonderful, wonderful book, and I highly recommend if you can listen to the audiobook. It's really, really great to hear his voice and also his singing on that album or that track. So if you'd like to know more, this is a snippet of a whole article I have over at my website where you can see cover of the book, there's a picture of Archie, there's also some quotes from the book and links on where you can get your hands on it. So please go to foreveryoungautobiographies.com/tellmewhy. I will have the link for you in the show notes. And I'd love to ask you a question, if you can leave it in the comments. Do you have a memory of a parent that you would like to share? So Roach really values any stories he was told about his father. And he really harps on about that. It's really, really important to him. So I'd love to know, have you got a memory of a parent that you would like to share? Please let me know in the comments here or over at the article. And you can always send me an email about anything to do with life stories. You could be planning, you could be doing the creating, the writing, the polishing, or the publishing. Leave me a comment, leave me a question over at foreveryoungautobiographies.com/contact. Now, when I started the show, I mentioned the Your Family Story system. This is a step-by-step system to interview a loved one and help them get down their life stories, get down their memories. And I show you how to do that in that system. But if you'd like to get a taste of this system, you can get the first three sections for free by going to foreveryoungautobiographies.com/free, and it will be there for you to just download and take a look. And if you're interested, you can then move on to the full system. So So I will be back again soon with another topic, and I'd be really grateful if you could follow, subscribe, like the show, share it with a friend, and leave me a review if you found it helpful. I really, really appreciate it. So until then, everybody, happy reading and happy writing.